So, in this session, we will be seeing working capital estimation based on cash cost. Okay, we have already seen that the working capital is a difference between current assets and current liabilities. So, your working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. So, to estimate work requirements of working capital, we have to forecast the amount required for each item of current assets and current liabilities, right? But in practice, there is another approach which may be useful in estimating working capital requirement. Okay, this approach is based on the fact that in case of current assets like sundry debtors and finished good, the exact amount of fund blocked is less than the amount of such current asset. Okay, for example, if we have the sundry debtors worth rupees 1 lakh and our cost of production is 75,000, the actual amount of funds blocked in sundry debtors is only 75,000. Okay, since the sundry debtors are valued on the sales, okay, sales price, the actual price that is being locked in the sundry debtors is only 75,000. And suppose, say, out of that rupees 75,000, 5,000 is your depreciation. Okay, then it is obvious that the actual funds block in terms of cash in sundry debtors, which was amounting to rupees 1 lakh, is only 70,000. Okay, so in this approach, what we do is the debtors are not calculated as a percentage of sale, but they are calculated as a percentage of the cash cost. Similarly, if you see finished goods are also valued according to the cash cost. The depreciation on machinery is not included in valuation of finished goods. Okay, so this is about working capital estimation on the basis of cash cost. So two things, sundry debtors, okay, so they are valued at cash costs. So that is, you have to reduce your profit margin and you have to reduce your depreciation also, since depreciation is non-cash. For finished goods, in another approach, you are valuing it at a total cost, but in this approach, you are valuing finished goods at a cash cost. That is your total cost. Production cost minus depreciation. Okay, so this is one more approach of calculating your working capital. Now let's see one example, okay, on how to calculate or how to estimate working capital based on cash cost. ESS Limited sells goods at a gross profit of 25%, considering depreciation as a part of cost of production. Okay, so its annual figures are as follows. So ESS is having a gross profit percent of 25% on sales value, and then it is considering depreciation as a cost of production, correct? Which is a normal practice, that depreciation of machinery is calculated and is included as a part of your cost of production. Now sales at 2 months credit. Okay, so sales it is giving at a 2 month credit to the debtors, that is debtors holding period is 2 months. Okay, it is 18 lakhs. Material consumed, that is raw material consumed. Suppliers extend 2 month credit. So credit availed from sundry creditors is 2 months. Okay, material consumed is 4,50,000. Wages paid monthly in arrear. Okay, so total wages during the year is 3,60,000, and monthly in arrear means the current month wages are paid in the next month. So at given point of time, 1 month wages are outstanding. Manufacturing expenses outstanding at the end of the year. Cash expenses are paid 1 month in arrear. Okay, so this is not total manufacturing expenses, this is only outstanding manufacturing expenses at the end of the year, that is 40,000. So, and they, since they are paid 1 month in arrear, 40,000 is your monthly expense. So your total manufacturing expenses will be 40,000 into 12. Okay, so that is 4,80,000. 40,000 into 12, so 4 lakh. 80,000 is your total manufacturing expenses for the year. Okay. Then total administrative expenses. So this is a total administrative expenses. So 1,20,000. This is also for the year. Okay. So out of which every month expenses are paid in the next month. Okay. Sales promotion expenses paid quarterly in advance. So 60,000 is your total sales promotion expenses. And out of 60,000, what has been done is for 3 months, quarterly in advance means 3 months expenses are paid in advance. Okay. The company keeps 1 month stock of raw material and finished goods and believes in keeping 1 lakh rupees in cash. That is, raw material holding period of raw material and finished good is 1 month and cash is 1 lakh. Assuming 15% safety margin, ascertain the requirement of working capital. 15% safety margin, in the sense, whatever is the estimate of working capital that you are getting, you have to add 15% to that as a safety margin. Okay, so additional provision of 15% to that needs to be made, and it has to be calculated on cash cost basis. Okay, ignore work in progress. Now let's start our computation. So first I'll prepare a working note number 1. Okay, so let's first see what is, for in this case what we have to do is we have to calculate your debtors and finished goods on the cash cost basis, right? So for that we need to ascertain what is the amount of depreciation. So let's first calculate the amount of depreciation. So computation of amount of depreciation. This amount of depreciation needs to be excluded from your debtors as well as your finished goods. Okay, so let's calculate. First, now total sales. How much is a total sale? 18 lakhs. Correct? Then from total sales, we'll reduce the gross profit first. So what is the gross profit margin? It's 25%. So 25% on sales. So 25% gross profit on sales. How much is that? 4,50,000. Correct? So 13,50,000 is your manufacturing cost. Okay, now if you read the first line, what has been given is depreciation as a part of cost of production. So this 13,50,000 includes depreciation. Okay, so to find out the amount of depreciation, what we have to do is we have to reduce what are the other manufacturing expenses that are included in this manufacturing cost. Okay, so manufacturing expenses or production expenses. So one is less materials consumed. Right, then materials consumed is how much? 4,50,000. Then wages paid. How much are the total wages paid? 3,60,000. Correct. Now let's reduce this. Okay. So if you reduce this, 5,40,000 is your total manufacturing expenses or overheads excluding your material and wages. So this is manufacturing expenses excluding material and wages. Correct? 5,40,000. Now what has to be done is, now to find out depreciation, we have to reduce all the cash manufacturing expenses. So if you see here, cash manufacturing expenses outstanding at the end of year is 40,000. Okay, and they are paid 1 month in arrear. Okay, so this is per month expense. So for the year, your manufacturing expenses is 480,000. That is cash manufacturing expenses. So your cash manufacturing expenses is 40,000 into 12, that is 480,000. Okay, so if you reduce 5,40,000 minus 4,80,000, you get 60,000. Now the 60,000 is a depreciation for the year. Okay, this is a reverse calculation which we have done and find out what is the depreciation amount for the year. Okay. Now let's calculate each and every current asset and current liabilities. Okay, sales at 2 months credit. So let's first calculate our debtors. Okay, so working note number 2. Okay, sundry debtors. Fine. Now sundry debtors, in this case, since it is a cash cost method, sundry debtors are to be valued at total cash cost. Okay, now total cash cost will be your total manufacturing cash cost plus selling expenses plus administration expenses. Okay, so your cash manufacturing expenses, what are your cash manufacturing expenses? Okay, your total manufacturing cost is 13,50,000. That includes your material wages and your cash manufacturing overheads plus depreciation. Okay, so total manufacturing cost, I'll put it here, 13,50,000, right? This is calculated in the above working note number 1. Okay, now less your depreciation is how much? 60,000. This is again from working note number 1. Okay, so your cash manufacturing costs is equal to 13,50,000 minus 60,000, so that will give you 12,90,000, right? So 12,90,000 is your cash manufacturing cost. You have to add your administrative expenses and selling expenses since you're valuing sundry debtors, right? Sales promotion expenses. So let's see how much is the administrative and sales promotion expenses. It's given here. Administrative expenses is 1,20,000 and sales promotion expenses is 60,000. So we have to add that 1,20,000 and 60,000. So your total 14,70,000 is your total cash costs. Okay, so your debtors holding period is how much? 2 months. Okay, we have seen it above, it's given, you can see it here. Sales at 2 months credit, so debtors holding period is 2 months. So 14,70,000 is your total cash cost for the year. So divide by 12 into 2. So that is 2,45,000. So 2,45,000 is your debtors amount. Next, materials consumed. Suppliers extend 2 month credit. Okay. So materials consumed, supplier expect 2 months credit. Okay, so we will calculate your sundry creditors now. Working note number 3, your sundry creditors. Okay, your material consumed is 4,50,000. That is for entire year, so divide by 12 into 2 months, because creditors are allowing us 2 months credit. So your creditors is 75,000. Okay, now the next one. Wages paid monthly in arrears. So outstanding wages. How much is the wages paid? 3,60,000 for the year. Okay, so let's calculate what is outstanding wages. Outstanding wages. Total wages is 3,60,000 for a year, divided by 12, and wages are paid monthly in arrears, so 1 month. So that comes to 30,000. Okay, then working note number 5. What is the next one? Manufacturing expenses outstanding at the end of the year is 40,000. Okay, it's directly given. Outstanding manufacturing expenses is 40,000. So we'll just specify it in working note number 5, just to keep a track. So working note number 5, outstanding manufacturing expenses. How much is that? 40,000. Now the next working note. Working note number 6. Total administrative expenses paid as above. Paid as above means 1 month in arrear. Okay. So how much is that? 1,20,000 is for year. So they are paid 1 month in arrear. So 1 month expenses are outstanding. So outstanding administrative expenses, correct? So how much is that? 1,20,000 is the administrative expense, divided by 12 into 1 month. So that comes to 10,000. So 10,000 is the amount of outstanding administrative expenses. Then sales promotion expenses paid quarterly in advance. Okay, so 3 months sales promotion expenses are paid in advance. So it will be advance sales promotion expense. It will be shown under current assets. Okay, amount, total amount is 60,000 for the year. So let's calculate what is the amount for 3 months. Working note number 7. Sales promotion expenses. Okay, 60,000 is the total amount, divided by 12 months into 3, so that is 15,000. Okay, paid in advance, so this will be under your current assets, right? Then okay, the company keeps 1 month stock of raw material and finished goods. Okay, so let's calculate for stock of raw material. 1 month stock of raw material. So total material consumed during the year is 4,50,000. It's given here, right? So 4,50,000 divided by 12 into 1 month. That will give you your stock of raw material, right? Note number 8, stock of raw materials, right? How much is the total material consumed? 4,50,000 divide by 12 into 1 month. That comes to 37,500. Okay, then the next Okay, finished goods also 1 month stock has been kept. So finished goods are there in the factory for 1 month. Now again, finished goods we are valuing at a cash manufacturing cost and not a total manufacturing cost. Okay, so your total manufacturing cost is 1,350,000. We have calculated it here, right? Out of this, your depreciation is 60,000. So your cash manufacturing cost is 12,90,000. So your stock of finished goods have to be valued at 12,90,000. Let's calculate. Working note number 9. Working note number 9 is for stock of finished goods, right? So total manufacturing costs is equal to 1,350,000 less depreciation is equal to 60,000. So 12,90,000 is your cash manufacturing cost. So stock of finished goods is there for 1 year. Stock of finished goods 12,90,000 divide by 12 into 1. So that comes to 107,500. Correct? So that is working note number 9. Now the next one. Cash is rupees 1 lakh, so it's directly given, it will come in current asset. So I'll just put it and specify it in working note number 10. Cash is 1 lakh. Now we will prepare a statement, okay, statement of calculating your working capital. So this is a statement showing estimation of the working capital on cash cost basis. We have pulled in the value from all the working notes here and prepared a statement. So you have current assets, in that you have sundry debtors, advance sales, promotion expense, stock of raw materials, stock of finished good cash. Then you have total current assets 5,05,000. Then current liabilities, you have sundry creditors, outstanding wages, outstanding manufacturing expenses, outstanding admin expenses. So that comes to 1,55,000. And then the working capital is A minus B, that is 3,50,000. You can see the working notes and the statement. Okay. Now there is one more thing. The last line of the example, assuming a 15% safety margin, ascertain the requirement of working capital. So whatever working capital we have got as per statement, what we have to do, we have to add a safety margin of 15%. Okay, so add 15% safety margin. So 15% of your 3,50,000. Okay, so that comes to 52,500. Okay, so here it is 15% of 3,50,000. That comes to 52,500. We have to add it. Okay, so this is what is a working capital requirement on cash cost basis. So 3,50,000 plus 52,500, so that comes to 402,500. Okay, so this was about calculation or estimation of working capital on cash cost basis. Thank you.